Okay, so good morning everyone. See, in the last class we have seen what is a data queue. Okay, then we have seen the different representations for data cube, that is 2D data cube and then 3D data cube and then 4D data cube, and then we have seen what is a dimension and what is a fact. Okay, so now coming to the next topic, that is schemas for multidimensional data models. Okay, so see here again, see, it is very, very important topic from exam point of view. See, if you look at the question papers, in each and every question paper, they have asked this question. Okay, so it is very, very important topic. Okay, try to read it properly. Okay, now see here, see, as I explained in the last class, we are going to use the ER model, entity relationship data model, that is for designing the relational database systems. Okay. So in case of ER model, see, we'll be showing the database schema in the form of entities and the relationships between those entities. See, I hope that see everyone remembers this one. In case of a DBMS system, see, you're going to design the DBMS system by first designing a ER model. And then see, in the ER model, you will be representing the entities and the relationship between the entities. Okay, so but this model, ER model, see, it is only helpful for the online transaction processing. You can't use this ER model for designing a data warehouse. So for designing a data warehouse, see, since in case of a data warehouse, say we need to represent that is each and every subject, that is main subjects which are present in a data warehouse, like customer, supply, product and sales. Since we need to represent these subjects, okay, and also we don't want to represent the detailed data here, we want the concise data. So in order to represent that, we will be using a multidimensional data model. So ER model will be used in a DBMS system. So in case of a DBMS system, we are going to represent the entities and the relationships between those entities. See, after designing that, we'll be designing a DBMS system. But in case of a data warehouse system, see here, since this data warehouse system is subject oriented, and since it is concise, see, we will not use the ER model here, we'll be using a multidimensional data model, because the ER model, see, it is not going to design a data warehouse in a format so that it will be helpful for us for data analysis. So we can't use the ER model here. So we need to use the multidimensional data model, which will be representing the subjects, okay, correctly, and also all those subjects will be represented in a concise format so that we can easily perform the online data analysis here. Okay, so now coming to the different multidimensional data models which are available here. See, mainly we have got three different kinds of data models here. One is star schema, and second one is snowflake schema, and then third one is fat constellation schema. Okay, so see here, multidimensional data model, say, it will be used for designing a data warehouse system, and ER model is used for designing a relational DBMS system. Okay, so in case of that is multidimensional models, we have got three different kinds of models here. One is star schema, and second one is snowflake schema, and third one is fat constellation schema. Okay, so now let's see what is this star schema, snowflake schema, and then fat constellation schema. Just try to remember this one. See, it is very, very important topic from exam point of view. So now coming to the first one, that is a star schema. Okay, so the star schema, see, it is very, very popular. That is the schema that is used for designing the data warehouse. Okay, so it is very popular and very common modeling, that is a paradigm which we will be using. Okay, so star schema, it is very popular among these three different schemas. So it is used in many of the applications here. Then how you are going to design the data warehouse using this star schema? So in case of a star schema, see, mainly we have got two different tables here. See, as I explained in the last class, see, in case of a data warehouse model, see, we'll be having two tables. That is, one is dimension table and second is fact table. See, same thing will be present in a star schema also. Star schema also contains two tables here. One is fact table and second one is dimension table. So we'll be having a large central table here. So in the center, we'll be having one large table. So that large table will be containing a large quantity of data here. Bulk of data will be stored in this large table. Okay, so that large table is called as a fact table here. But But in this large table or the fact tables, you will not be having any kind of redundancy. Redundancy will not be there. Redundancy means that duplicate data. Duplicate data will not be stored in a large table here. Okay. So that is first table. Second table, see the smaller attendant tables, see those are called as dimension tables here. So we'll be having a dimension table for each of the dimensions. See, if you have got total four dimensions, so there will be total four dimension tables available in a star schema here. Okay. So remember this one. See, star schema, see, it is very, very popular. That is modeling paradigm here, or it is very, very popular model. It has been used in many of the applications to design a data warehouse. See this, in this star schema, see, we have got two tables here. So one first table is called as a fact table. So this fact table, it will be containing a large quantity of data. Bulk of data will be stored in case of a fact table. Okay. So it is called as a large central table because it will be located at center of the star schema. So it is a large central table. It will be containing bulk of data, but there will be no redundancy present in a fact table. So second table, that is a set of smaller attendant tables. See, it is called a smaller table because the quantity of data which is stored in a dimension table will be less here compared to a fact table. Okay. So we'll be having a set of smaller attendant tables here, which are called as dimension tables. There will be a dimension table for each of the dimensions. If you've got three dimensions, then there will be three dimension tables. If you've got four dimensions, then there will be four dimension tables. Okay. Then why this is called as a star schema? Okay. So star schema, see, the reason for calling it as a star schema is, see, just I will show you the example. So see here, see, this is an example for a star schema that is for all electronics sales data warehouse. Okay. So now just see here. See, if you look at the shape of this table, it approximately looks like a star. Okay. So in the middle, we have got that is a fact table. And then see, diagonally, we have got the dimension tables here. So these dimension tables are linked to this fact table. Okay. So it looks like a star here. So it is called as a star schema. Okay. So in case of a star schema, so we'll be having two tables here. One is the fact table and second one is a dimension table. See, fact table will be stored at the center. Okay. And it is called as a larger table because it will be having bulk of data, large quantity of data will be stored in a fact table. Okay. And then see, a second table is smaller attendant table. Okay, that is called as dimension table. So we will be having a dimension table for each of the dimensions which we have got in a data warehouse. Okay. And this star schema, see, it is called as a star because the reason is that, see, at the center, we have got the fact table and diagonally, we have got the connection of the dimension tables. Diagonally, these dimension tables are connected to this fact table. So the shape of this table, schema, it resembles like a star. Okay. So since it looks like a star, so only it is called as a star schema. Okay. So here dimension tables, they are displayed radially or diagonally. Okay. Around the central fact table here. So only it is called as a star schema here. Okay. So now see here. So if you look at the star, that is a fact table and the dimension tables. So in case of fact table, okay, so we'll be having keys, okay, just like you, how you got keys in a DBMS system, okay. So in the same way, so in case of dimension tables also, we have got the keys here. So which are the different dimensions here? Time, item, branch, and then location. Okay. So time, item, branch, and location, total four dimensions we have got. And for each of the dimension, we have got one table here. If you look here, so we have got one table for the time dimension, okay, and then we have got one table for the item dimension, and then we have got one table for the location, and then one for the branch. So now coming to the dimension table, so each dimension table will be having attributes. Now if you consider time, so the different dimensions for attributes for the time are time, normally we'll be having a key here, so that is time key, and then day of the week, and then month, quarter, and year. See, all these are attributes which are present in time. So in the same way, so if you come to item, so in case of item, we'll be having item key and then item name. and then brand, type, and then supplier. All these are attributes which are related to item. And then coming to branch, so branch key we have got, and then branch name, and then branch type. Okay. And then for location, we have got location key, street, city, province, or the state, and then country. See, all these are attributes. They are going to define the dimension tables. Okay, these are the contents of dimension table. Now coming to fact table. See, in case of fact table, so we'll be having the keys of the dimension table. So what is the key of that is dimension table item? Time, that is time key. Okay, that will be stored here. Okay, then in case of item, item key, that is stored here, and then branch key, and then location key. See, all these keys, they will be linked to the dimension tables. So keys will be stored. Apart from that, we'll be having measures. Okay, so I told that, see, in the last class, see, we'll be having keys of the dimension tables which are linked to the dimension tables, and then also we'll be having measures. So measures are nothing but numerical measures. Those are also stored in a fact table here. So here measures are dollars sold and then units sold. Okay, those are stored here. Okay, so this is about the star scheme. Okay, so but the disadvantage of the star schema is, so see here, see, for each of the dimension we have got only one table. So each of the dimension is represented by only one table here. Okay, so now if you have got a one table, see, that table may create a redundancy or duplicate data. That is the disadvantage of a star schema. Okay, so I will tell you one example. See how this is going to create a redundancy here. See, for example, see, we have got the two, that is the cities, that is Urbana and Chicago. See, these are the cities which are present in the state Illinois, and the country, that is US. See, Urbana and Chicago, these are the cities which are present in the state Illinois, and then country name is USA. Okay, so now if you look at the entries for these two cities, okay, so they will be stored like Urbana and then Illinois and then USA, Chicago, Illinois, and then USA. Okay, so this is how they will be stored in the, that is location dimension table. Okay, now see here. So if you look at this Illinois and then USA, it has been stored twice here. Okay, so same data, it has been stored twice in the location dimension table. So only it is going to create a redundancy, because say, since we have got only one dimension table for each of the dimension, okay, that is going to create the redundancy. So how that redundancy is created? See, for example, if I consider the two cities here, so that is Urbana and Chicago. See, these are the cities which are present in the state Illinois, and then the country name is USA. So now if you look at the entries here in the dimension table, they will be stored like this: Urbana and then Illinois and then USA. Chicago will be stored like this: Chicago and then Illinois and then USA. So this country name and the state name, that is repeating here, it is stored twice here. So only it is going to create a redundancy. That is the disadvantage of the star schema. So now, in order to avoid this disadvantage, so we'll be using the second schema, that is a snowflake schema. Okay, so snowflake is nothing but see, you might have seen that is in case of a fridge. Okay, there will be a formation of snowflake. So snowflake will be just like a hierarchical structure. You might have seen that in a fridge. Okay, so the snowflake schema, see, it is going to look like a snowflake here. Okay, so I'll give the example later, you can understand it. So the main reason for using this snowflake schema is, see, we want to reduce the redundancy that is stored in a, that is star schema. So in order to avoid that, so we'll be using a snowflake schema. So in case of snowflake schema, so again, it is a variation of a star schema here. But the thing is, see, we'll be normalizing the dimension tables in the snowflake schema. Normalization is nothing but we'll be splitting the dimension tables in case of a snowflake schema in order to reduce the redundancy or duplication of data. That is the difference here. See, in case of star schema, see, since we have got only one dimension table for each of the dimensions, it is going to create redundancy for some of the entries there. Okay, so in order to avoid that, we will be using the snowflake schema here. So snowflake schema, see, it is a one kind of a variation of a star schema. See here, we'll be dividing the dimension tables into two or more tables here in order to avoid the redundancy. In order to reduce the redundancy, we'll be dividing the, that is dimension tables here. That is called as normalization. Dimension tables are normalized here. Okay, that is, we are going to split the dimension table. Okay, so now this snowflake schema, since it is going to resemble the structure of a snowflake, so it is called as a snowflake schema. Then what are the advantages of snowflake schema? So one difference I told between this snowflake schema and star schema is that, so in case of snowflake schema, see, we will be dividing the dimension tables into smaller tables. Okay, two or more tables, we will be dividing that. So because of that, see, since we are normalizing the dimension tables here, it is going to reduce the redundancy. That is the obvious advantage. So one advantage of using the snowflake schema is, see, it is going to reduce the redundancy here. So second advantage is, see the tables will be very easy to maintain, and also it is going to save the storage space. See, since you are going to divide the tables, dimension tables into two or more tables here, so it will be quite easy to maintain here, because we will not be having redundancy, so it will be quite easy to maintain. And also, obviously, see, if you don't have the redundancy, then it is going to save the storage space also. So star schema, see, in case of star schema, we'll be having two tables, that is a central fact table, and then second one is smaller attendant tables, that is called as dimension table. So in the same way, in the snowflake schema also, we'll be having a fact table and the dimension table. But the difference is, in order to reduce the redundancy, we'll be dividing the dimension tables into additional tables. We'll be splitting the dimension tables into additional tables here. That is called as normalization. So what are the advantages then? See, since we are dividing the dimension tables into smaller tables here, so it is going to reduce the redundancy. That is first advantage. Second advantage is, see, it will be quite easy to maintain, and also it is going to save the storage space. Okay. So now coming to the snowflake schema here. So see here. So if you observe this diagram, again, it is almost similar to the star schema only. But the difference is, so I'll not explain again these tables. Okay, I already explained what are the contents of these tables. Okay, that is, we have got four dimensions here, time, item, and then branch and location, and then we have got a central fact table. See, the attributes are same here. Only thing is, see, if you look at the item dimension table, see, the supplier, that is a type, it has been formed as a new dimension table that will be containing the two attributes here, supplier key and then supplier type, that has been attached to this table. Okay, we have splitted this item table into two dimension tables here. One is item and then supplier, and then we have linked the supplier key to this table. Okay, so here the reason is, we want to avoid the redundancy. See, supplier type will be creating redundancy here, so only we have splitted this item table into two subtables. So in the same way, so as I explained in the previous example, see that city, it is going to create the redundancy city attribute. So in order to avoid that, we have splitted this location dimension table into two tables. That is, one is location and then city. And then we have linked this city key to this location dimension table. Other attributes will be same, city key and then city, province and state, and then country. So only thing is, we have splitted this into two dimension tables here. That is, we have normalized the dimension table. Okay. So that is in order to reduce the redundancy. So here, see, this item table has been divided into two dimension tables. That is item and then supplier. So in the same way, location has been divided into location and then city. Okay. So now coming to the disadvantage. Okay. So disadvantage of the snowflake schema. So see here, this snowflake schema, see, it is going to increase the magnitude of the fact table. Okay, that is one of the disadvantage. Okay, so disadvantage of snowflake schema is, first disadvantage is, it is going to increase the magnitude of the fact tables here. So it is not going to increase the size of the fact table, only magnitude will be increasing here. That is first disadvantage. Second disadvantage is, see, suppose if you are trying to run a query here, okay, so at that time you need to join the tables here. Okay, so if you got a query on the item dimension table, then you need to join this item and the supplier tables here. Okay, so at that time, so it is going to reduce the effectiveness of browsing. Okay, So why this browsing effectiveness is going to reduce? Because you need to perform more joins. Similarly, if you got a query on the location dimension table, then you need to join location and then city. So it is going to that is reduce the effectiveness here, and then ultimately the performance of the system is also going to reduce. Okay. So disadvantages are, one is it is going to increase the magnitude of the fact table, and second one is, see, whenever you are performing the query here, then you need to perform more joins because the tables are splitted here or normalized. So in order to improve the performance, in order to run a query, so you need to perform more number of joins here, so that is going to reduce the performance of the system here. That is the second disadvantage. Okay, so now coming to the difference between the star schema and the Snowflake schema. See, already I have explained this. So first difference is, see, in case of the star schema, see, will be having denormalized dimension tables. That is, dimension tables will not be splitted here. But in case of Snowflake schema, we can have the normalized dimension tables. That is, we will be splitting the dimension tables into two or more tables. That is first difference. Second difference is coming to maintenance. In case of a star schema, see, since we have got a redundancy, because we will not be having a normalization here, so there will be more maintenance in case of star schema. But in case of Snowflake schema, since there is less redundancy, there will be less maintenance here. That is the second difference. So here, that is more maintenance here in case of star schema, but in case of Snowflake schema, less maintenance because there is no redundancy. Then third one, coming to query. So in case of star schema, there will be simple queries here because we'll not be performing joining because we have not divided the dimension tables into smaller tables here. So there will be simple queries here. Okay, but in case of Snowflake schema, say since we have divided the tables into sub dimension tables, so we need to join the tables here. Because of that, there will be complex queries. And then coming to number of joins here, there will be less joins in the star schema, but there will be more joins in the Snowflake schema. Okay. That is about the joins. Okay, then coming to when we need to use the star schema and then Snowflake schema. See, suppose, if you are bothered about the speed and the performance of the system, then it is better to use star schema. Okay. So if you want to get the results faster and if you want to improve the performance of the system, then better use the star schema. And then Snowflake schema. See, Snowflake schema, normally it is used whenever you are worried about the integrity or the duplication of the data. So I hope that, say, everyone understood these differences. So first one is about the normalization. See, there is no normalized dimension tables in the star schema, but we have got the normalized dimensions tables in the Snowflake schema. Second one is about the maintenance. See, in case of a star schema, see, there is no redundancy. There will be redundancy, so there will be more maintenance here. But in case of Snowflake schema, there will be less redundancy, so there will be less maintenance. Okay, coming to query. So we can use the simple queries here. We need to use complex queries in the Snowflake schema. And then joins. See, there will be less joins here. But here in case of Snowflake schema, there will be more joins. And then usage guidelines. See, we'll be using star schema whenever we want higher performance and then higher speed system. And Snowflake schema will be used whenever you want the integrity, whenever you are worried about the integrity and the duplication of the data. Okay. So this is about this second schema. And coming to the third one, that is fact constellation schema. In case of fact constellation schema, we will be having multiple fact tables also in order to share the dimension table. See, in case of star schema and then Snowflake schema, as I have shown here, here we have got only one fact table in case of star schema. In the same way, in case of Snowflake schema also, we have got only one fact table. But in case of the fact constellation schema, we'll be having multiple fact tables here. You can observe here, we have got multiple fact tables in case of a fact constellation schema in order to share the dimension tables. Okay. So why it is called as a fact constellation schema? Okay. So it is a collection of star schemas here. Okay. So collection of stars is called as a galaxy. Okay. So in the same way, collection of star schemas, so it is called as a galaxy schema or a fact constellation schema. Okay. So when we need to use this fact constellation schema, so fact constellation schema is used whenever you are designing sophisticated applications. So sophisticated applications or the larger complex applications, see, they require the multiple fact tables here in order to shape the dimension tables. So since it is a collection of stars, so it is called as a galaxy schema or a fact constellation schema. Okay. So now example. So see here, again, same thing we have got here. That is time, item, and then branch, and then location. So additional thing is, say, sales fact table, that is also same. We have got one more fact table here, that is shipping table. Okay, it has got the multiple fact tables. So only it is called as a fact constellation schema. So now, so see here, in case of shipping fact table, see, this is same. So that is same keys, and then the measures are present here. This is same. Coming to the shipping fact table, so it has got the item key, and then time key, and then shipper key. That shipper dimension table is additional here. That key is present here. Okay, and then from location and to location, those are the that is attributes of the location table. Apart from that, see, we got two more measures here: dollars cost and the unit ship. Those are the contents of the shipping fact table here. Okay. Just try to remember this. See, fact constellation schema. So it will be having two or more fact tables. But in case of star and snowflake schema, so it'll be having only one fact table. But in case of fact constellation schema, there will be two or more fact tables present. Okay, this is one example here. We have got two fact tables here. That is sales fact table and then shipping fact table. Okay. So these keys you can remember. Okay, just try to practice this one, then you can easily try to remember that. Okay, so now I'll repeat that again. So that is first one. See here, in case of star schema, see, we have got two tables here. That is a central larger table, that is called as a fact table, and then smaller attendant tables, those are called as dimension tables. Okay. So this central table will not be having redundancy, but these smaller tables, they will be having redundancy. Okay. Then why it is called as a fact table? Star schema. So star schema, the reason for calling it as a star schema is, see, because it will be resembling a star here. We have got a central fact table, and diagonally the dimension tables are connected to this fact table. So since it resembles a that is star, so it is called as a star schema. Okay. Now coming to the disadvantage, see, there will be redundancy in case of some of the dimension tables here. So I give the example for that. Just try to read it. Now coming to the second one, that is snowflake schema. See, in case of snowflake schema, see, we'll be normalizing the dimension tables here. Normalization is nothing but we'll be splitting the dimension tables into two or more dimension tables here. Okay. So see here, the item dimension table has been divided into item and then supplier dimension tables. And here location dimension table has been divided into location and then city dimension table. So the dimension tables have been normalized here. Okay. Advantages. See, one advantage is it will be reducing the redundancy. And second advantage is, see, it will be quite easy to maintain, and also it is going to save the storage space here. Okay. Then what are the disadvantages? I told. See, disadvantages are, it is going to increase the magnitude of the fact table. And second disadvantage is, since we need to perform more joins here, so there will be more number of joins, then it is going to reduce the effectiveness of browsing. Okay, ultimately, it is going to reduce the performance of the system here. Okay, that is the disadvantage of the snowflake schema. And third one is, differences are explained already. And third one is fact constellation schema. So in case of fact constellation schema, see, it is mainly used for designing the sophisticated applications. So in order to design the sophisticated applications, so we'll be using this fact constellation schema. So in case of fact constellation schema, we'll be having multiple fact tables here. Okay. And the dimension tables has been shared by these fact tables. Okay. So this is about the three different schemas. Okay. So next topic, so better I will discuss in the next class. So now if you got any doubts, you can ask me.